Hi, I'm Kyle, and today I'm going to be listening to the second half of Speak Now, Taylor's version. Now, this is the second half, so obviously I've done the first half. Check that out if you want. It was an absolute vibe. I loved it. Welcome to Taylor Tuesdays as well. It'll either be a full album or half an album, because some of them are very, very long. Every Tuesday until I'm done, I think. This is the order I plan on doing the albums. Let me know if there's any adjustments that need to be made, if they're correct. Hopefully they are. Spent a lot of time making sure they are, but please let me know. And yeah, subscribe if you're excited to come on this journey with me. Let me know what you think down in the comments. The full uncut version, everything like that, will be on Patreon if you care. If not, completely fine. And yeah, if you fancy it, leave the video a like. Why not? But yeah, let's jump into the first track I'm going to be doing today. This is the 12th one on the album though. That is number 12, that is Haunted. Some long songs coming up as well. Some long old songs. Let's do it. Okay, straight in. This is very different to Innocent. You and I walk a fragile line. Oh no. Oh, okay. Oh no. It's the end. It's the end. Can't trust anything now. Can't trust nothing. Nada, no one. Ooh. Ooh, lose you again. Oh, sing it.
Okay, I won't tell
her. I won't. Okay. Oh no! Don't leave me like this. Oh. Right. I'm sweating already. Oh my god.
Bruh.
Okay, the relationship's crumbled. It's done. It's over. It's finito. Until it's so heartbroken by it that she's haunted. Is that dramatic? It's like you're being haunted by a poltergeist or something. No! Watched you walk away. I mean, maybe it was a blessing though. Bye bye. Oh. Oh no, Taylor, that poor man. That poor man. Oh, oh, my breath. This melody. This melody. This is so 2000 and I love it. I love it, I love it, I love it, I love it. Oh, it gets up. That's what I'm saying, I love the production on this album. It's so invigorating, so cool. Oh, she knows. She knows. Oh my god, the way she's singing it. Ooh. Break it down. Break it down. Oh my god, Miss Taylor, wait there, I need that again. Okay, so we're continuing the theme of just like absolutely amazing 10 out of 10 vocals. Okay, I'm with you, Taylor, I'm with you.
Sing it.
And it's gonna break. Oh, she's known it all this time. So you knew it was coming eventually. Oh, that's a bit of juxtaposition though, isn't it? You and I walk a fragile line. I have known it all this time. Never ever thought I'd see it break. Never thought I'd see it. So you know when it was fragile. You knew it was a rocky relationship, but you never thought you'd see the end. Okay. I mean, what a way just to get straight back into the album. I think doing that in the middle was absolutely perfect. Like, just a perfect halfway point. Because that was a great kind of like reintroduction of what Speak Now was and the vibe. I mean, I can't say I'm with you on that. I've never been haunted by a relationship, so God, it must have been a traumatic event. Okay, now it's over track 13, Last Kiss. Okay, we're slowing down, thank God. Because I cannot be sweating this much already. Oh, Taylor, why are we doing things at this time?
We know it's the devil's hour.
Why did you go? Oh, no. Oh, I do. Okay. Oh, it's on in the production. The smell of the rain. Because we were kissing in the rain. I remember that. Oh, just to think of them. Yeah. Oh, no. How to be something you miss. Oh. Oh, put yourself and it's over. Right, okay. All that I know is I don't know how to be something you miss. So I'm guessing you really want them to miss you, so they will come and take you back and then you mean that happy relationship again. But is it worth it, Taylor? It's probably not worth it, alright? If they're moved on, it's traumatic and it's hard, I know, but we're gonna have to persevere, we're gonna have to pull through. I never imagined we'd end Oh, like when you get your lip tattooed. I can hear it. Same, I would roll my eyes as well. I'm gonna be sick of it. Oh, right, I'm getting the visuals. I'm getting them. No. All that I know is I don't know how to be something you miss. Lyricism. I want to say Enchanted, like, because I know there was a song, I figured it's called Enchanted, but like, not the same vibe as that song, but like, just the word Enchanted, did that make sense? Okay. Oh, oh no, we need to get over it now. Oh, imagery. It's a beautiful day. It is today. But I never planned on you changing your mind. Oh, that breaks my heart. Taylor, I can't be dealing with this trauma, this heartbreak, alright?
It's a movie about trauma. The movie is about trauma.
Especially on a slow song. Your slow songs are normally about something like happy. How to be something. I'm gonna cry for you, Taylor. Just like our last. Oh, quite a long outro. Not the biggest fan of that, Taylor. I don't like a silent outro. Okay, so I've just went from like having a massive like rock pop party to completely slowing it down and now my heart's broken and I'm gonna cry. That's gotta be some of my favourite lyricism. I don't know if it's gonna be my favourite song, but definitely some of my favourite like lyricism and like just so emotive. I could feel it all. Oh, I'm sorry if I'm missing references. I'm sorry if I'm missing references to old songs. It's been a little bit since I listened to the first half, so if I missed them, I can only apologise.
Oh, sorry.
But it's time for track number 14, and that's called Long Live. Long Live the King. Picking it up a bit, I think. I can never tell. This could go completely sad. I don't know. She likes to switch it up. Remember this moment. I'm remembering. In our shaking hands, crowds and stands went wild. So are we like famous or something? Oh, is it gonna be like from King Queen or something? Ooh, production, pick it up. History book page. End of a decade, star of an age. Long live you all. Oh, yes, like, from Queen, from King vibes. We'll be remembered, there on the sidelines, pushing for right now. Okay, so you were there in the background, with them, and now you're in that moment. I'm guessing this is about something, like, specific, though, that I'm not aware of, because this sounds like a very specific situation. I said prom king and prom queen because I just know that's a very American thing. Could be completely off, I don't know. We are the kings and the queens. Well, you're definitely the queen. And we help them up for our hold your trophy up. Hold it. Celebrate. wait, Taylor. Are you screaming in the back of my ears, Taylor? I love the attention to detail. Pretenders. I love the way she sings that. Pretenders. Oh, like a fantasy. That's how strong it was, like a fantasy. Oh, I'm holding. Wait. I'm gonna need that again, Miss Taylor. But yeah, this is about a good, very, very happy memory by the sounds of it.
I wish I won anything so I could feel like that, but no.
I promise you, whatever you need, Taylor. You'll stand by me forever. Yes. Please tell my name. Oh. Not afraid. Oh my god, Taylor, you cannot build me up like that and then just completely end it. Just completely like that. Oh my god, I feel empowered. I feel euphoric. I can take on the world. I can do it. Oh, you've got me sweating again. But yeah, it's a happy song. And it sounds like it's like a very, very specific memory. So please let me know because, I'm presuming she might have said it somewhere. I don't know. I could proper see this as a music video though, like fully playing out in my head as I'm listening to the song. I can picture like each act, all the movements, everything. Okay, time for track number 15, and that is called Hours. Nope. A bit more country, I'm guessing. Sounds a bit more country. The silence makes me wanna take the stairs. Oh, I would never take the stairs, you're alone there. Taking the stairs. Oh. No. There always is. Always is. Yeah. Yeah. And you can do nothing about it. Because everyone's opinion is right. Oh, right. That's it. Oh. That's another voice. Oh. This feels so happy. Do you know what I mean? Like, Yeah, the stakes are high, the waters are up, but this love is ours, so people are judging, and they're like, you shouldn't be together, blah blah blah, which I imagine happens a lot for Taylor in the position that she's in, the fame and everything. She's being like, I choose you, I choose you, and I will always choose you. Oh no, is this who you're with? Is this who you're with? Oh, so the exes! Oh, but she doesn't care. Oh, I could do that every time, I'm sorry. I feel jolly. I just feel jolly. It's not. Why do you care about other people's business, alright? Why? Oh, you've written this song for them. I want someone to write a song for me. They're gonna be ignored. We're in the cutest love. Oh, it's a cute one. Yeah, people are gonna judge. That's life, unfortunately. People always have opinion on everything. But you know what? As long as you know what's going on, then it's all good. That's all that matters in the end, isn't it? If yous are happy, and it sounds like yous are, because they're lovers. Well, I was going to say ours, yours, not ours. That was a very jolly song though, if that makes sense. It was, yeah, this is the dance move I was doing the whole time. Just like this. That's how I was feeling. I don't know if it's going to be my favourite, but you know what? There's 22 songs, so not everyone is going to be my favourite. That's alright. Okay, it's time for track number 16, and that's called Superman. Oh, like Rocky, couldn't be rock. That's the new genre I'm calling it. Dark and Superman. Oh god, he's perfect. It's the same thing to me. Oh, dang it. Wait, oh, if you're not saying anything more. Oh. Oh, right, what I was going to say though, so is this Taylor talking about someone who she's not in a relationship with, like they're not actually together? Also, sorry if I sound like I'm dying, it's because I am, I'm being quite ill. But yeah, I always forget to tell you I love you forever, so is that because they're not in that relationship, but she desperately just wants to be like, please, I love you, please. I'm an electric guitar. Might not be electric guitar, I could have made that up. Complicated, he's irrational, but I... Ooh, wait, one thing I've noticed as well so far, The first verse is always like really happy and it's the good things, and then the second verse is like the kind of, I guess, the negatives, the more bad things, like he's complicated, he's irrational, but like still, you know, wanting to be with them or stay with them in that relationship or whatever. Just something I noticed. I don't know if she does that often. Someday you'll take me away. Oh! And save the day. The day. Something is. Oh no, he's a bad boy. Can't be falling for the bad boys, Taylor. I love it. Come back, I'll be with you someday. Don't wait there, production. What I was also going to say is it is very relatable. Like, we've all had that person that, you just want to grab them by the hands and say, why aren't we in a relationship? This isn't fair. Maybe literally. Oh, no. I will not. Ooh. Quickly, so is I and I Watch You Fly Around the World, is this about like an ex who was like famous, so they might literally be flying around the world, you know, doing like, I don't know, a tour or whatever? Let me know, please. Oh, we made that. I will not do it, I promise. Well, at least you're getting them from someone else. Some people can't say that, i.e. me. Oh, the fizzle, the fade. But yeah, could that literally be about, you know, a famous ex who was like flying around the world or whatever, like on a tour or something? She is just the relatable queen, like we've all been there, literally staring out a window, all sad and depressed when you were younger. Just being like, please, please, for the love of God, could you just telepathically read my mind that we should be in love? Don't make me see it. Right, now it's time for the first track from The Vault. It's track 17 and it's Electric Touch featuring Fall Out Boy. I actually know who Fall Out Boy is, so let's go. Okay, similar vibe to Superman in terms of genre. Just breathe, just relax, it'll be okay. We're deep, okay. Ever hanging out with you. Oh, is this the first time? Are you nervous?
But I'm starting to get a bit shaky, you know? I mean, I'm a little bit weak. Of stories and
still you too. Just one time. Please, just one time, let it go well, please. Oh. Oh, have you just described yourself as a ghost town, Taylor? That's not good. Long? Oh, there they are. I recognise that voice. But yes, she just described herself as a ghost town. Got a feeling your electric touch could fill this ghost town up with life. You know it's going bad when you can describe yourself as that. Oh, but meeting someone new, so you know, you're excited, this all could go well. Ah, my fingers are crossed for you, Taylor. They're crossed. Trying hard not to look like I'm trying. Right. No one calling my phone. I didn't know I wrote this song. Were they in my mind when they wrote this song?
Just one. Please. Just one time.
Electric. Touch. Oh, this bang and forth. Just one time, maybe. Probably not, but maybe. Sing it! Bug. Golf. Production! Wait, I'm gonna need that again. I'm sorry, I'm sorry if you hear it when I repeat, but. Oh, I didn't know we were getting vocals. Oh, I hope it can. I hope it ends. Wow. Okay. I am sweating once again. Okay. You have done it. A question about the Vault tracks. So was this originally meant to be on the album? So was Fall Out Boy an original feature on the album of this song? Or are they just a feature now because it's been reprised from the vault? Or yeah, how does that work? Let me know. I'm going to be completely honest. I'm going to give you my complete honest raw opinion. That and Superman were very similar songs. I don't know if they were different, you know, for me. They did sound very, very similar.
That's my opinion!
And I think I preferred Superman. ICL, I can't lie. I can't believe she described herself as a ghost down the wall. That is, oh, bless you, Taylor. Bless your heart. Okay, time for track 18, When Emma Falls in Love. Who the bloody hell is Emma? Let's find out. Ooh. And we get a piano ballad. Taylor's voice on a piano ballad. Oh.
There's the blinds and locks the door.
Oh, why? Why is she being so secretive? When Emma paranoid. Falls in love, jokes about the ways that this one could go. Oh, that's very fair. That's very, very fair, Emma. Who is Emma?
Thinks it's gonna rain.
Oh, pessimist, I'm with you, Emma. Forever a pessimist, glass half empty.
Boy will never be the same.
Oh.
She's the kind of
Cleopatra. Right, she's a goddess. Who is Emma?
Boys will be good boys.
Oh. Ah, so the other way around.
Tell you the truth. Sometimes I wish I was.
Well, from the sounds of it, me too. It's so obvious. Okay, first of all, was there any need to go that deep, Taylor? You are really reaching at my soul here, okay? I mean, yeah, Emma sounds like she's a bit of that bitch. Wouldn't we all want to be Emma? I can't lie, she sounds like the person to be.
I can set my gun
down. I am
down.
That bitch,
I'm
that bitch. Oh, she's one of those people, I guess, in the relationship, and then it's, you never see them again, they never hang out anymore. I hate people like that. Oh, Emma, we can't be doing that. We need to share our emotions. We need to share.
Oh,
look, the sister head voice for your best friend. No, what a good turn. Just melts me away. So, yeah, we're comparing ourselves to Emma, because she is apparently better. Oh, she's gonna give you the tea.
Oh no.
Is this in a good way or a bad way though? I don't know. I don't know. Emma sounds like that bitch. Alright. Sounds like that bitch. Oh. She's betrayed us, Taylor. I see. Wow. So who is Emma? Is she Taylor's friend or something like that? To be fair, Emma doesn't sound that perfect. Emma sounds like, you know, when she's in a relationship, it's 100%. And that's not always the best, you know, you've got to take it step by step, gradually, sometimes. Or maybe Emma just is that bitch. I don't know. Maybe I'm just reading it all wrong. Yeah, Taylor, we shouldn't compare yourself to Emma. I don't know who Emma is, but everyone is different and they're loving their own way. Whatever that means. Does that mean to me something? Okay, now it's time for track number 19, I Can See You, Taylor's version. Hello. Okay. Switch it up. This is completely different.
You brush past me in the hallway and yet I can see it.
Wait, Miss Taylor. I need that again.
Ooh.
Right, have we been stalking them?
Ooh,
it was a secret. Why would it be a secret? Oh, okay, Taylor. Okay.
Horny bitch.
Ah, if you only knew. I can see you. I love that. So I'm presuming we're not with this person, and this is like a person we want to be with, we want to be in love with. But for some reason, it needs to be kept secret. What would you do if I went to touch you now? What would you do if they never found us out? So why do we want it kept a secret? Are they like bad boys or some forbidden love that like your family isn't going to approve of or something? Many questions. So let's see if they get answered.
And we kept everything professional.
Oh, we kept professional? Does that mean something's happened? Oh, I'll be quiet, I'm sorry. The fantasizations. It's a word. I'm with you, that fantasizing everything. Yeah. You've got everything, every single thing planned out.
Now, no hope for me.
Ha ha, screaming. Taking all the clothes off. I won't do that. I love this complete switch of our production though. Oh. Is this like a fan fiction or something? Taylor Swift is a real fan fiction. Wait. You can see me as a secret mission. So yeah, why is it a secret? Why does this have to be some secret forbidden love? Is it because it's like just a fling or something? Oh, I don't know. Behave yourself, Taylor. This is just filth. This is just pure horny filth.
I love it.
Oh, we've been seen. No, oh, baby. Ah, we've been seen by Miss Taylor. Getting such a cool, like, perspective for a song. Like, I don't know. I don't normally hear songs in that way. Love the absolute just completely change of a production. Like, it's a completely different vibe. I do have to be honest. I think I prefer the vaulted tracks on Fearless so far. There's still three of them left, so there's still some to go. But I think, yeah, the vaulted tracks on Fearless were just, I don't know, a little bit better for me, personally. I don't know. Okay, it's time for track 20, Castles Crumbling, featuring Hayley Williams. Now, I'm pretty sure that's her, our paramour, isn't it? I believe. I was not expecting this for a song featuring Hayley Williams. All right. Ooh, once, so what's happened? Why is it crumbled? When you were the kings, remembering the kings and queens. Oh, why do they not know? Oh, this sounds like it's going to be personal. Oh no, you won't, Taylor. You will not do that. Oh. Abduction. Wait. So, is this like a real life like experience about fame and everything? Because obviously she's had two albums before this. So is this like a genuine like, God, like I fear people aren't gonna like me anymore. Like, did she go through like a rough patch in terms of like popularity or fame or something? Dynasty, crowds. Ooh, her voice fits perfectly. Oh, we've held a grudge. Oh, we've had a power trip. About what though? Oh no. This feels like very real. Very real. No, but I do. I promise I do. Ooh, background vocals. But okay. She said, power went to my head and I couldn't stop. Ones I love tried to help, so I ran them off. Is that like a real thing? Has this actually happened? If so, then well done for being so open. Like, wow. I could never be exposing myself to the world like that, so well done, Taylor. I feel like I'm in heaven. Literally in heaven. Oh, has it though? People look at me like I'm a monster. Oh, that's a ghost. Oh, Swift. Oh no. So this actually happened. Oh, okay. Calm it down. This like enchanting vocals. Oh, strip it back. Ah, there's voices in my head. Ooh. I mean, I probably could have got that from the title of Castle Scrumlin, but that was a very powerful song. But again, yeah, was this about something that actually happened? If so, that is horrendous. People like actually shouting that they hate you. I mean, I guess that wouldn't happen being famous, I guess. But it sounds like people have like switched, they've done a 180, they've gone from loving you to hating you. Hayley Williams has a beautiful voice as well, so very well done on choosing that feature. That was a good one. IMO. Okay, it's time for track number 21, Foolish One. Okay.
My cards are on the table.
Oh. No. This isn't going to be good. No, it's Taylor, the Foolish One.
I will talk myself to sleep again.
Same, Taylor. We can talk each other to sleep, all right? We can do that.
To keep my hopes to
stringing you along. Just stringing you along. Yeah, when you're in this situation, you block out anything that makes sense.
Hey! 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 You idiot!
Anything that makes common sense.
The exception. You with four confessions alive.
Yeah, I'm sorry, it's made me laugh and I need a cough. I'm laughing because, like, it's just so true. We've literally all been there, ignoring all the common sense, ignoring everyone that's been like, what are you doing? Like, if you look back on yourself, you'd be like, what on earth were you doing? Are you okay? Hello?
You know how to keep me waiting. I know how to act like I'm
yeah,
fine.
Yeah, you pretend it's okay. Yeah, it's fine. I'm fine.
Best to seem bulletproof.
Oh, she's mentioned about being bulletproof in the songs before. I don't know which one, but she has.
This is something we'll laugh about.
You've convinced yourself that it's not, like, wrong.
You will never learn.
Oh, I'm with you.
Check in your mailbox for confessions of love.
Oh, no. How
could I not see this?
How have you missed the massive red flags?
On your own.
Oh, no.
Me in the wing.
Wait, because you got her on your arm and me in the wings. Oh my, I mean, if that doesn't sum it up perfectly, just in the background, like, open, like, please, you'll bring me on one day, please. Oh no.
I will finally learn my lesson.
Probably not. We never will, Taylor.
Like
I said, we can be finished together, Taylor. Alright, that's fine with me. Hey!
Oh,
switch it off. Switch it off. You just wasn't the one. And you will find the one. You will find the one. And these feelings will be validated. Oh, at least that's what I tell myself. Ooh, production. Yeah, let's be foolish together, Taylor. Alright, we can be foolish together. We can. We can confide in each other about just how awful our love life is, how everything just goes wrong. Okay, it's time for track 22, it's the final one, we made it, and this is called Timeless, so let's go. Oh, so we're slowing it down for the end. I see. Oh, we're still getting an amazing melody though. I also see.
There was a cardboard box in the sand, said photos, 25 cents each, black and white, so it's the porch of the first house.
Oh,
I'm
timeless.
In a lifetime.
Timeless, yeah.
I called you and it's so hard to
explain. Right. I'm guessing we've saw them.
Photos, I saw
yes.
Us
that could be us. Probably won't be, but it could be. Oh, okay, she knows it's what. Okay, I was about to say. That would have been us sat on the porch, living our lives of our first house. So these actual photos that she's found. Yeah, these actual photos that she's found, like, is this a true story, walking into the antique shop and finding all that? If that's true, does that mean, like, she actually rang someone when that happened and everything? I mean, I'm asking yous as if yous actually know the answer, as if you, I'm presuming you just know everything about Taylor's life, so you're gonna know. Oh, no thank you. No thank you. Don't care, it's not worth it. Don't like spiders.
Hundreds of years ago,
wow. Like Romeo and Juliet. Oh God. We're getting all the history lessons. Even through the atrocities back then, we still would have found a way to each other. It's a sweet song. It's another sweet song. Just get lost.
Story started when you
Hello. Hi.
Hi. I'm gonna love you when our
hair is turning gray. Like photos of the life we've made. Yeah, and then sell them to an antique shop. Oh, I hear the background voices. Something in your head is just like, I should go in there. It's fate. It was meant to be. That's the only way to see it. Oh, that was a cute, like, nice little, just happy, vibey note to end up on, though. Yeah, it's a nice kind of summary, sum off of the album, I would say. Okay, wow, that's it. That's Speak Now Done, my very second Taylor album. Done and complete. I love the bit of the genre switch, you know, first album was a very, very country, this had a bit more pop and rock influences, which is really cool. I mean, next we've got Red, and I know some of the songs up there are very pop, and I'm very looking forward to that. Yeah, these are my rankings of the songs, if you care. I hope they're not too bad. I hope you don't disagree too much. I hope your favourite's not down there at the bottom. But yeah, I only have the two to compare it to. But I think my overall thought is, I think Speak Now as an album is better. I think I prefer kind of, yeah, that genre switch. I think I'm going to go back and listen to a lot more of the songs. However, I do think the vaulted tracks on Fearless were better than the vaulted tracks on Speak Now. But I think that's because Speak Now was a lot more different. Like, there was a much more of a mixture, whereas Fearless had a very similar vibe the whole way through, so then the vault tracks were like much more of a difference. But yeah, that's just my opinion, and who cares about that? Who cares? Yeah, let's read some of the reviews for Speak Now. I want to know what the general vibe is, what the critics were saying. Someone told me that Fearless actually won Album of the Year, the original one, when it came out, so I want to say well done to Taylor for the album. 97% like this album on Google. I feel like every single album I've looked at on Google said 97%. I'm just saying. Oh, Pitchfork gave it a 7.5. Was Fearless the same? I think it was also 7.5. Taylor Swift's catalogue re-recording campaign continues with a thoughtful version of 2010 Speak Now that tempers teen angst with the ageless quality of lullabies and folk songs. Yeah, sums up perfectly, I think. I think so. Rolling Stone, 5 out of 5 stars is that? Hear this. Taylor Swift expands our image of landmark album with Speak Now Taylor's version. She channels the original's LP exuberance, does a little revising, and brings along some pop-punk pals. That's it, pop-punk. I think that's the phrase I was trying to say. I love the pop-punk aspect. Swift wrote and recorded Speak Now while on the precipice of her teenage years. Ah, okay. So this very is that teenage, very teenage love. Aha, which had roots in country while taking cues from the then dominant Warped Tour, believed strain of pop rock. Pop rock? I knew it, I was right. Okay, we'll have a look at the Metacritic version. 81, think that's fair. 92 user score, very fair as well, very, very fair. Oh my god, who is this person? Griffin Horn. So bad she can retire, please, she has gotten worse and worse at singing. Hope to never listen to one of her songs again. Jesus, who hurt you, Griffin? What has Taylor Swift done to you, Griffin? God. What would I give it out of 10? What would I give it out of 10? I think I would agree with Pitchfork. I think I'd say a 7.5 for me personally. I didn't do Fearless. I think I would give Fearless a little bit less. Maybe like a 6.8 and a 7. Just because, yeah, that couldn't revive. I appreciate it. Appreciate the lyricism, but that couldn't revive. And, you know, not really for me. Whereas this had a lot more poppy songs that I definitely am going to be going back and listening to. Always appreciate the lyricism and I can picture it all in my mind. Yeah, that's it. Taylor's version done. Speak Now, Taylor's version done. Next will be Red. And I know some of the songs on Red. And I love some of the songs on Red. So get ready for a party. Subscribe if you wanna come along with me for that. I know what you thought of this album down in the comments. And anything you think would be useful to know about this album. And useful to know, you know, going into Red. Follow Uncut Version on Patreon, all that. If you care, fine if you don't. It's just there if you want. Yeah, thank you so much for watching. It's been a vibe. I hope we had a vibe. I'm presuming you like Taylor, so you know going through this again has been fun for you as well. But yeah, thank you for watching. Hope I see you again, and yeah, till next time.